In this video, I discuss the residual dividend model. Under the residual dividend model, a company pays out whatever income it doesn't need to invest in new projects and keep its current capital structure. Therefore, dividends equal the net income minus retained earnings to finance new projects. The retained earnings to finance new projects is going to be calculated by their target capital ratio, their target equity ratio, times their new capital budget, which is commonly written as WS, the equity fraction for the company, times CB, the capital budget, where WS, the company's equity fraction, plus the debt fraction has to add up to one. Dividends can also, of course, be calculated as net income minus retained earnings. For example, we're going to consider a company with a net income of $10 million with a target equity fraction of 60% and a capital budget of $3 million. Their retained earnings that is required is therefore going to be the 0.6 times the 3 million, or $1.8 million. The dividends that can then be paid out will be the net income of $10 million minus the retained earnings of $1.8 million, or $8.2 million can be paid out in dividends. If this is the number of shares the company has outstanding, then the dividends per share will merely be the dividends divided by the number of shares, or 82 cents per share. Since economic conditions vary from year to year, the net income of a company tends to fluctuate. What if it was $10 million the first year, but goes up to $12 million the next year, and down to $7 million the year after that? Well, under each of these conditions, the company would need $1.8 million in retained earnings to finance new projects, but the dividends paid out would fluctuate quite a bit because the net income has changed and the extra money the company does not need to finance expansion changes. So if the net income goes up to $1.2 million, the retained earnings stays the same, but the dividends, which again are going to be net income minus retained earnings, now go up to $10.2 million, or $1.02 a share. And in the final case, the net income has dropped substantially. The retained earnings stay the same, so the dividends decrease, again, this being net income minus retained earnings, to $5.2 million, or only 52 cents a share. So time period to time period, what a dividend recipient receives changes drastically. You can see this on the graph, dividends go up or down. People commonly invest in dividends for the purpose of income to retire off of, paying their rent or their daily living expenses, so there really is no clientele for a drastically fluctuating dividend payout. This is why companies tend to not use the residual dividend policy, but they might calculate it to figure out, well, based on past earnings, what's the minimum dividend we can easily pay out? And then they might look around that range and keep that as a constant dividend. I thank you for watching this video.